Hey everybody, how's it going? Hey Mayuko, what programming language should I learn?
Well, Python is clearly better than Ruby.
Objective-C, what is this, the Stone Age?
HTML is complete and utter trash. JavaScript is the way to go.
No, don't listen to them. C is the best place to start.
Well, honestly, it really depends.
What?
You said that last time.
Okay. Well, if you're just starting to learn how to code, then picking the right programming language is not as important as picking up fundamental coding skills. Although, if you're trying to choose a programming language for something that you're going to build, then the best programming language is going to depend on a variety of factors. So let me talk about that first point. If you're starting to dive into the wonderful world of programming, then it doesn't matter too much what programming language you'll start with. Your goal should be getting used to writing code. You're gonna learn a lot of basic skills like how to write code with the correct syntax, how to run your program, and how to debug it. These are the skills that are really important to develop early on in writing code. They're the tools that are gonna help you write any program you want. And the best part is, these skills are transferable across programming languages and serve as a really important foundation for your coding journey. I learned Java as my first programming language because it was a programming language that my intro to computer science class used. I learned how to use for loops, while loops, if-then statements, and learned what variables and functions are. I also learned how to run my program and debug my code. We didn't study the intricacies of the Java programming language, nor did we study where it came from or how it came to be. We were all just getting started on learning how to code, so we stuck to the basics. So to give you all a place to start, I recommend starting with a programming language that's currently really popular. Today in 2018, I would say they're Python, Ruby, JavaScript, and Swift.
Because I'm partial to iOS.
A popular programming language is going to have a lot of documentation for you online if you get stuck on something, and that can be really helpful when you're starting out so that you can get unstuck easily. Another way to choose which programming language you should use is to read a couple of lines from different ones and see which ones look interesting or easy to understand for you. We all think different, and so finding a programming language that comes naturally to how you think is going to set you up for success. Okay, so that second point. If you're choosing a programming language for building something, then the best programming language is going to depend on a variety of factors. Each programming language was invented for a different need. Yukihiro Matsumoto invented the programming language Ruby because, end quote, "I really wanted a genuine, object-oriented, easy-to-use scripting language. I looked for one, but couldn't find it. So I decided to make it." Apple created the programming language Swift 4 years ago to create the best available language for a variety of tech stacks and to make writing and maintaining correct programs easier for the developer. If you think about that, then each programming language is going to shine and be best used in different scenarios. You can think about factors like what computers or software is available to you. For instance, you can only make iOS apps if you have a Mac. What are you most comfortable writing? For example, if you have a delivery deadline, then choosing something you're comfortable with is going to help you ship faster. How many people are going to be working on it? Consider how easy this programming language should be for people on your team to understand and contribute to it based on their individual skill sets. Once you understand those constraints, then consider your options by doing some research. I'll note that it's really helpful to find something that is well tested and well used by the developer community. That means you'll have less trouble using it, which can provide an overall better experience. Okay, so I hope this explains my answer. There isn't one objectively best programming language out there. It's true, when I was younger, I had a lot of people around me who had strong opinions about programming language and frameworks, and I thought it was like cool to have a really strong opinion about those things too, but honestly, it's not. It's whatever. As a software engineer, it's really important to solve your problem based on what the best available options are and to really understand what you're trying to achieve and what the constraints are. Once you understand that, choosing the right programming language should come really easy. All right, everyone, that is it for today. Stick around for the end for some announcements, but if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell to get notified for my videos that are out every week. Okay, so my first announcement is that I started doing monthly live streams starting this month, which you can check out on my channel. They will be on the first weekend of every month, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram or Twitter, where I'll be posting details about my live stream about a week leading up to it. So I hope to see a lot of you there. It's a fun time. I usually talk about updates on my life and also do a quick Q&A at the end. So hope to see you all at the next one. My second announcement is that I have two shoutouts to give. So if you post on social media with the hashtag HeyMayuko with something that you're working on or something that you're proud to have accomplished, then you might get a shoutout at the end of my video. The first one is from Kezia at KeziaSpams on Instagram. She says, I started learning Java a week ago and now I'm creating an app to help students be productive when studying for my CS project. I freaking love coding. I may look stressed and start talking to myself. When I get a feature to work, I'm over the moon. That's awesome. Thank you so much, Kezia, for submitting this, and good for you. This is like incredible. So thank you so much for submitting that. The second shout out goes to Pixel Peach at PixelPeach221 on Twitter. She says, months ago, I was unsatisfied with my job prospects. Your channel inspired me to build the coding skills I learned as a biologist and make the switch to software engineering. Oh, I now have the best job ever and feel like I'm really making a difference with tech. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing this. That means so much to me. So that is awesome. I'm cheering for you. I'm rooting for you. Thank you so much for sharing. So don't forget to tell me what you're working on or something you're proud about with the hashtag HeyMayuko, and you might get a shout out in my next video. Other than that, I think we're done. We're actually done this time. So I will see you next time. Bye.